I just want to come on here and kind of sound the alarm on something. There's a race war coming, and that may or may not be a surprise to some of you guys, but what will surprise you is it's actually being promoted within the body of Christ, which is mind-blowing, because we're supposed to love one another. Jesus said that he wanted us to become one as he is one with the Father. And the gentleman that you see on the screen here, I've been following for probably a few years now, off and on. And he's got a group of people that are just anti-white following him. And he never, ever, 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 ever corrects them. Ever. Which basically means that he's complicit in their attitudes and their racism. Now, he'll deny it. And basically what this goes and boils down to is he is a member of the black Hebrew Israelite believers, some people say cult. You know what? And I don't have a problem. If he wants to believe that Jesus is black, I'm okay with that. Because I don't care if Jesus is black or white. You know, my research and everything leads me to believe that he was of olive skin. But he's got this group of people within his organization that follow him that believe that he's black. And he himself teaches that Jesus was black. And what they've done is they're taking this and they're running with it, and they're using it as a reason to be just openly, insanely aggressive towards white people. And some of the comments that they're making, I mean, are insane. And speaking of insanity, even this pastor says, makes comments like, the problem you people are having is a total lack of respect for a man of Yah, or Yahweh. Who are you to instruct me? Stay in your place. Stay in your place, white folk. Stay in your place. Because this guy knows a lot more than you do. Do you guys see the problem with that? I mean, the mentality, the division, the separation, the haughtiness. It's mind-boggling that a pastor would come right out and say things like that. And if you go through and read the comments, I mean, I've been working on this guy now for a few weeks, and, you know, he'll make a post, I'll reply, and he'll never reply to my comeback. So, you know, basically, he's a scripture-tweaking sniper. And, you know, he comes up and he says something, and then you respond to it, and he never addresses it, never verifies that, you know, you have a valid point or whatever. And so I replied to him and said, I can easily talk to you. As you put it, this man of Yahweh. As I happen to know him very well myself, I remind you, none are righteous. No, not one. And all fall short of the glory of God, including you, Pastor, as well as myself. So stop it with your puffed up self. You're a legend in your own mind, not Yahweh's mind or mine. So get a grip. Again, you have the same problem Peter had. And if you read my post the other day, you would know what that means. Did you? You never gave me the courtesy of a reply. Do you actually think you know it all? Really? Surely not, unless you've lost your mind. And I could go on and on. But basically, this is a real quick summary. Is Peter had a vision three separate times. And we had been having some discussion over what clean meat and unclean meat are. These guys are still trying to live under the law of Moses, saying that certain meats are unclean. And I've given them countless Bible verses that clearly state there's no such thing as unclean meat because it's a ceremonial issue, not the meat itself issue. And when Christ became the last sacrifice, the final sacrifice, then all the ceremonial issues went away. That's the reason for the clean and unclean meats. These guys refuse to see it. They're a bunch of legalists, and they're still trying to live under the law of Moses. And they mix up the law of Moses and the Ten Commandments. They're not one and the same. They'll never admit it. Never, ever. No matter how many times you explain it, no matter how many scriptures you put right in front of them, they'll dance. So, but that's not really the main issue that I want to, you know, cover here. What I want to cover is the open racism that this guy is allowing. Now, he makes his dig on the white man, but the people in his group are much, much worse. And like I said, he's not, his pastor's job is to lead the flock, to correct heresy and false teaching. He doesn't. He doesn't do that. Therefore, he's complicit in this. And so, if you read some of the comments from his people, it's mind-boggling. I mean, like this guy here, he flat calls white people the devil. He says, and when the white man painted and betrayed everyone in the Bible as being white, you devils rejoiced and sat around the fireplace with your eggnog singing joy to the world. There was no cry from none of you devils about the lie that was being perpetrated on the world. But oh, now that the Most High God is waking people up to the deception, you lie. You devils are in an uproar trying to use the race card to silence this teaching. And it goes on and on. So basically, the point of this video is to warn you, there's a race war coming. And that may or may not be a surprise to some of you, but I guarantee you what is going to be a surprise to most of you is it's going to be even in the body of Christ. That's mind-blowing. And, I mean, some of these guys, it's clear. That'd be the guy that pulled the string on the guillotine, thinking that they do God a favor. And that's exactly what the Bible says. And that's exactly what's prophesied. We're in trouble. And we need to expose this. I mean, I hate to tear another brother's ministry down, but he's got some real issues. He's got a group of people, and he's fermenting racism. And he'll make the occasional video and stuff and try to smooth over it and gloss over it and stuff. But the more I've looked at it, he's behind it. I mean, he's complicit in it. And I hate to say that. It breaks my heart to say that. I don't want to believe that. I want to have unity within the body because we've got all these other things coming on the earth that are going to be horrible. And the last thing, again, the last thing that we need is racism in the body. So, you know, one of the points I want to make is the brothers and the sisters that you think that you're going to be able to rely on when it hits the fan and other enemies come at us, whether it be Russia or China or North Korea or whoever. Not that I really promote making enemies out of Russia or China, but you know, the immediate problem is this problem, because we don't even know who is loyal to the Lord and his body. And so this just adds another problem to the equation that we need to address. You need to identify who the wolves are in the church. And the Bible talks about that, that there are wolves in the church. Well, you're looking at one right here on the screen. And Pastor, I tell you what, it breaks my heart to say this if you see this video, but you got a problem. Your job is to manage your flock, and your flock is completely out of control, and you're doing nothing to fix this. Okay? Therefore, you're complicit in it. And then you're making videos, you know, actually mocking the situation that, you know, crypto Israel are upset. Come on. That is just openly instigating what these people are doing. So, you know, I'm here as much as I don't want to be divided. Being a watchman on the wall, I have no choice but to notify any and everybody who will listen to what you're doing. And this is just the beginning, okay? Just letting you know, it's just the beginning. Because I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. The truth will come out.